Today, I'll be explaining what Future is Bright Phase 3.0 has done to continue revolutionizing realistic lighting in Roblox. On the day of recording this video on August 1st, 2020, Future is Bright Phase 3 is currently in beta testing, which means that any new features that have been added will not show up if you try to play the game outside of Studio until it is fully released around October to December of 2020. I will only be showing the new features of this phase, so if you are interested in what Phase 2.5 added, you can go to the card at the top right of the screen or find it through the tutorial playlist in the description below. To enable the new features of this update, make sure you've turned on the Explorer and Properties tabs through the View tab at the top left of the screen. From here, click on Lighting, go down into the Properties, and change the technology setting to say Future. Make sure that you are using over 5 bars of in-game graphics quality or have the Edit Quality level through the Rendering tab in Roblox Studio Settings set to at least level 10 or higher in order to see its effects. The largest improvements have been seen with point lights, spotlights, and surface lights. I'll be showing a before and after with the old and new settings for each of these sections. Point lights emit light from a single point in every direction. So if we go into this room here and change the point lights properties over here, we click on it, go into the property setting, and I change the range property to something higher, it's going to reach every single part of the room. So since we're using the future setting right here, I'm going to go into the lighting and swap it back, and this is what it looked like before with shadow map, and this is what it looks like with future. And if we go on the outside of this room, you'll notice that there is some slight light leaking improvements, but that's not the same in every single case. Spotlights emit light in a single direction in an almost cone-like shape from the center point. So if we go over here to this spotlight and we move it closer to something or change its angle property, the point of light will either become wider or narrower. The shadow this now creates on other things within the environment is now much more noticeable and refined. So if I compare it over here to shadow map, and this is future, shadow map, this is future, it is much more refined as shown through the shadows of some of my YouTube members trying to change out a light bulb. Surface lights emit light in a single direction directly from the surface of the object it is attached to. You can choose any of the surfaces. This happens in somewhat of a boxy shape as shown by these different lights here in descending height. Surface lights have seen similar changes to the other lights if we compare the shadow map versus the future light setting. However, these updates currently do not support shadows from surface lights as shown from these differences ahead. While a spotlight over here with shadows enabled will not shine through the part below it, surface lights don't do that currently during Future's Bright Phase 3. This might be something that gets supported in the future, but that would be outside of the Future's Bright series. Since there were major changes from this update, there are things that you need to consider if you want to use this in your games. To start, only players that use 5 graphics bars or higher in-game will be able to see the future lighting. Anyone that has below that amount will default to shadow map or voxel settings, which could lead to certain cases like the post shown on the screen from other developers. However, it has been noted by one of the Roblox staff members that this could be improved in the future, but it would not be part of the Future's Bright updates. Another thing to remember is that since this lighting update makes some things look more realistic, it could make your games laggier and limit overall performance, which might make it difficult for some players who might have lower-end PCs or on a mobile device to enjoy your game on a graphic setting that allows them to see the new changes. One user has found a drastic decrease in performance in their game, going from around 200 all the way down to 100 FPS on their menu screen. There will hopefully still be performance improvements made to these new settings from Roblox, but it will likely remain laggier than other lighting settings. Also, it was mentioned in the original post by Roblox staff that shadowed point lights will cause worse performance than shadowed spotlights, which is probably because point lights emit light in all directions, so keep that in mind when you're selecting what lights to use. Remember that you will likely need to make a lot of adjustments in your game to make sure that you are able to see during different times of day, primarily inside of buildings that were reliant on few to no light sources. There are also some bugs when swapping between future and shadow map, so keep that in mind and make sure you're checking between both so that you know what certain users will see on lower graphic settings. If there are any changes to any of the features from this update in the future, please check the announcement thread that I will put into the important links section in the description below. If you're interested in using more lighting techniques to improve your game, I have tutorials on atmosphere and depth of field which can be found through the card at the top right of the screen, along with the playlist in the description below. If you have any further questions, please comment down below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Anyway, hope that you guys have a fantastic rest of your day. I'll see you all next time.